be to God in the highest. Amen. Amen. Now, but an hour now we're going to be celebrating the new year by the grace of God. We're very, very grateful that God is a very good God. He's a very wonderful God. He's a magnificent God. A lot of people, we have a lot of challenges this year. Very, very challenging. Year of persecution, year of COVID-19. There were a lot of things that could go wrong, went wrong. But yet, God kept us here. He kept us here for the purpose. We belong to Jesus. And God is for us. The Bible says, God be for us, who can be against us? He that is not spare his only begotten Son, but having delivered for us all, how shall he not freely to him give us all things? God is a very, very wonderful God. He's a magnificent God. He's a terrific God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Bible says, everything he has, but this is the perfect will of God. God is a very awesome God. God said, I will never forget you. I will never leave you nor forsake you. That you may boldly say, the Lord is my helper. We need to practice the presence of God. We need to be aware that no matter what we are going through, that God is for us and God is with us. And he will never leave us nor forsake us. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. We need to understand that God is a very wonderful God. He's an all-powerful God. He's all-knowing God. Hallelujah. To know him is to love him. To know him is to have a confidence in him. But I don't want to quit on me this year. I don't want to give up your work with me this year. Put your hope in the Lord. Put your trust in the Lord. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. Hallelujah. Before you make any kind of decisions this year, you need to tell yourself, ask yourself a question. Am I trying to do this by myself, or do I need God to help me to make this decision? But the Bible said, Proverbs 3, verse 5, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Lean not your own understanding. This is a year that is a very important thing that we don't lean to what we feel or what we think. We have to go by what God says. Hallelujah. Be led of the Spirit. Don't be led of the flesh. Don't be led by people's opinion. Hallelujah. The Bible says, as many as are led by the Spirit of God, and the sons of God. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord with all your heart, lean not to your own understanding, in all your ways. Acknowledge him and shall direct our path. The problem is that we don't read the Bible enough. Read the Bible with the intention of obeying what we read and applying what we read to our life. Romans chapter 15, verse 4. So whatever was written in the former days was written for our instruction. So that through endurance, saints don't give up, through endurance. If you don't quit in this season, God will reward you greatly if you don't quit. Hallelujah. When you've done everything you need to do, stand and stand some more. If you don't stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. It's a year of division. People that want to go with God, go all the way. People that don't want to go with God, this year they're going to get colder and colder. I think they're okay, but they become lukewarm. And lukewarm and colder and colder and colder. Hallelujah. God said, I got something to show you this year. Eyes have not seen, ears have not heard, that as they enter the heart of man, the thing that God has in store for them that love him. The Bible has been revealed to us by his Spirit. So in the flesh, you never get it. It's revealed to us by his Spirit. You belong to God, and God belongs to him. God belongs to you. He belongs to us. Hallelujah. So remember one thing, John chapter 14, verse 27. He said, my peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world give I unto you. Amen. Let not you have the trouble, neither you be afraid. Hallelujah. It's a year which you have to ask God for wisdom. God will not force himself on us. He can either get your answers from the wisdom of man, or you can ask God for his wisdom without doubting, without any doubting. Because the Bible says, he that doubts receives nothing from the Lord. So when you ask, ask in faith. When you ask, ask believing that God is all-powerful and God can do everything that he promised he will do. God love you. They care about you. You are somebody to him. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You see, the word of God is forever. It's incorruptible. It's always been. The word of God is God. He do have no beginning of days or the end of life. Hallelujah. I got something for you here. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8. And the grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of the Lord will stand forever. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of the Lord will stand forever. Let us this year make up our mind to go with God all the way. No matter how things look like, no matter what it feels like, may hold on to God, hold on to his unchanging word. He'll never leave you nor forsake you. We boldly say, the Lord is our helper. May we make up our mind this year. And nothing shall separate us from the love of God. Nothing shall separate us from the love of God. That's Romans chapter 8. Thank you, Jesus. There is something here too. He said, all of us have made mistakes. None of us have arrived yet. But the only thing we have to do is to forget those things which are behind. Once God forgives us of sins, we need to let go of those sins. Don't hold on to it again. As if to say, God's love or God's forgiveness is not enough. That's a religious spirit. There's nothing you can do to change your past. Only God can forgive us of all our past failures and our past deeds. But God says, I love you. It's an everlasting love. I'm not looking at those things. Forgetting those things which are behind. Press on to those things which are before you. Press on towards the mark of a high calling of God in Christ Jesus for your life. Hallelujah. It's a year in which you cannot be reflecting on your past failures. You have to reflect on God's victories for your life. And that's the good news. That's the only thing I got to tell you. It's the good news. The good news is not that we didn't do any wrong. We did wrong, but Jesus Christ, He took all our pain and ache and everything else. But He loved you because He cared about you. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. So there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. This is Romans chapter 8. Because it's true, Christ Jesus, the Lord, the Spirit, who gives life and sets you free from the loss of sin and death. All the Lord was powerless, He could not do because He was weakened by the flesh. God did send by sending His own Son, likeness of a sinful flesh, as a sin offering. Hallelujah. Amen. So God say, hey, don't live according to how you feel anymore. Live according to what I say. I say, I forgive you, that's what I mean. I say, you are more than a conqueror, that's what I meant. I say, you are above me and not beneath, that's what I meant. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Lots of times we don't even know where to start. You are one with our situation. The Bible says that there. Romans chapter 8, verse 26. Likewise, the Spirit helps us in our weaknesses, but we don't know how to pray as we ought to pray. Holy Spirit, I help us to pray according to the will of God. Hallelujah. He that searches the heart knows what is in the mind of the Spirit. The Spirit intercedes for God's people in accordance with the will of God. And we know that all things work together for good, that I will love God and are called according to His purpose. For if for no, He also did predestined it to be conformed to the image of His Son. So no matter what we are going through, no matter what trial and tribulation we are going through, for the conformation to the image, so we can look like Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Yeah. This is a very, very important verse of the scripture. And this is for the saints who want to be in the discouraging mode all the time. God said, I don't want you to stay in the discouraging mode. I don't want you to quit on me. Don't give up on me. Put your hope in God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. He said, no, this is verse 36. Amen. As it is written. Amen. Oh, let me see. Here it goes. 35. Amen. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Who shall separate us? Or what shall separate us? Is there anything that can happen in your life that we can give up on God? That's what can separate you. So make sure you get rid of that. So you can stay close to God no matter what. Stay with Christ no matter what. Where can we go? That's the word of life. Stay with Christ. Don't quit this year. Don't give up this coming year. Hold on to God so you can see the victory. He promised us victory. And do not return back to vote fully. Put your hope in God. Depend on Him. Hallelujah. Oh, thank you, Jesus. Who shall separate from the love of Christ? Shall trouble or hardship or persecution? Some people when they come to their house, no to candles, for the first time they just quit on God. I mean, the relationship with God is so loose that any small thing that happens like this, they're willing to let go of God, who is supposed to supply everything. He is the shepherd, we are the sheep. Hallelujah. Who shall separate from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, hardship, persecution, famine, and nakedness, or danger of sword? As it is written, for your sake we are killed all the day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Verse 37, no, in all this as well, more than a conqueror through Him that who loves us. Verse 38, extremely important, I'm convinced or fully persuaded. I'm not going to quit on God this year. I'm not letting go of anything this year. Where can we go? Here is the word of life. So unless you eat my flesh and drink my blood, you have no life in you. So this is hard teaching. Who can endure it? People are living left and right. He didn't say, oops, I made a mistake. Because he was not looking for a crowd. He was looking for people that will follow him all the way no matter what. Hallelujah. So don't be a fan. Amen. To be a fan and a follower. A follower will read the Bible and do what they read. A fan, he can say yes or no. Hallelujah. Don't be a fan. Be a follower. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. But 37, no. In all this is Romans 8, 37. No, in all these things we are more than conquerors in our lovers. So I'm fully convinced that neither death nor life, neither angels nor demons, neither present nor the future, nor any powers, nor any height or depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God. And this is in Christ Jesus our Lord. So no matter what you do, hold on to your Christ this year and I see you through by the grace of God. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. At this time, I want to just yield and have the ministers of the gospel to share with us. Minister Moran will get to share. Minister Jenny Taylor will share. Minister Malod will share. Amen. Praise God. Keep the faith. All right. So, Minister Moran.
Hello. Yes. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So, for the sake of time, you can read Judges chapter 17 to chapter 21 for the sake of time. When you get, I mean, later on, you can read Judges chapter 17 to chapter 21. But for tonight, we're going to focus on Judges chapter 21, verse 25. It says, in those days, there was no king in Israel. Every man did that which was right in his own eyes. This means, since there was no king, there was no law and order. So everyone did what their flesh wanted with no conviction. In the Old Testament, there were kings who ruled in Israel. But now, these days, at present, those of us that have given our life to Jesus and have confessed Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior, what we have done is we invited Jesus Christ as our Lord and Savior to live inside of us, to lead us, to guide us, and protect us. Jesus is the King of kings and the Lord of lords, who lives inside of us and has given us his words in the Bible to guide and to lead us. Every time that we go against what the Bible says, we are doing what is right in our own eyes and not in the eyes of God. This is not to condemn anyone, but to get us to take a side in 2021. And hopefully, we will be on God's side. As we are in our different homes at this time, take an inventory of 2020. How we have disobeyed God by yielding to our flesh, by going against what God commanded us and ignoring the Holy Spirit inside of us. The people around you may not know how you have gone against God, but God knows and you know. There's a popular saying that everybody that we all say is popular. We say God is a God of the second chance, third chance, and many chances. This is true, but have you ever thought about it, that there's a time that God will not give any more chances? Yes, the day that a person dies and the spirit is separated from the body, the soul is separated from the body, there will be no more chances. No more chances. The person will be judged by whatever they have done up to that time, up to that minute. That's what the person will be judged. Will be judged by. So there's a time that there's no chances anymore. And nobody, none of us know when the end will come. None of us know the end. So which means, whichever side you are, at that minute, when the time comes, that is what you are taking to eternity. We are very fortunate that we are still here, that we are here about to enter 2021. It is not by our doing, we are not so good, or we are not so godly that we are here. God has given us another chance to be godly, another chance to be obedient to Him, to allow the Holy Spirit to lead us. God has given us another chance to allow the world to see Christ through us. Our families are watching us. We are being watched on the job. Our friends are watching us. Let us make up our minds to do God's will in 2021. This is not in our own strength. Ask the Holy Spirit for help and allow God to be proud of us in all our thoughts and our actions. Nobody knows when the end is. Nobody knows. Whatever you are doing, whatever side you are, when the end comes, that is it. No more chances. No more chances. The Bible says in the book of Joshua. The Bible says in the book of Joshua, chapter 24, verse 15. The Bible says, but if serving the Lord seems undesirable to you, then choose for yourself this day whom you will serve, whether the gods your ancestors served beyond the Euphrates or the gods of the Amorites in whose land you are living. But as for me and my household, we will serve the Lord. As we start 2021, let us ask God to forgive us for all the times that we did what was right in our eyes, but it was evil in God's eyes. Let us choose to be on God's side and stay there permanently. Let us be godly examples in our homes. Let us be godly examples on our jobs and everywhere that we go. Let people see Christ in our homes. Let people see Christ in our marriages, in our household. Let our actions show that Jesus Christ has risen from the dead. Let people see Christ in how we talk to people, how we talk to each other, in our thoughts about other people, just thoughts that nobody else can see, nobody else knows but only God. Let Christ be reflected in our thoughts. Let Christ be seen in our relationships and in every area of our lives. Forgive others and forgive yourself. 2021 is another chance for us. For some, it's the second chance. For some, it's the 10th chance. And for some, it's 101 chance. Whatever number of chance it is for you, for each of us, let us get it right now. Now is the time. There's no other time. Right now is the time. Let us get it right as we're about to get into 2021. I'm going to pray right now. I'm going to pray Psalm 51 for us to ask God to forgive us for repentance for all the times in 2020 that we have done things that we think are right in our own eyes, but even in God's eyes. Father God, we come to you in the name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We come to you, members of Light Park Christian Church and guests that we have on the conference line. We come to you in the name of Jesus. We thank you. We pray, Lord, that you have mercy on us according to your unfailing love, according to your great compassion. Blot out our transgressions. Wash away all our iniquities and cleanse us from our sins. Lord, we know our transgressions. In 2020, we did things that are right in our own eyes, but evil in your eyes. Help us, Lord, to yield to your guidance, to yield to the guidance of the Holy Spirit. Help us, Lord, to listen and be led of the Holy Spirit. Help us, Lord, to do things that are right in your eyes. Thank you, Lord, that our sins are forgiven from the day we are born until today. Lord, as you have forgiven us, help us to forgive each other and forgive ourselves. Cleanse us with hyssop and we will be clean. Wash us, Lord, and we will be whiter than snow. Let us hear joy and gladness. Let the bones you have crushed rejoice. Hide your face from our sins and blot out all our iniquities. Create in us a pure heart, O God, and renew a steadfast spirit within us. Do not cast us from your presence or take your Holy Spirit from us. Restore to us the joy of your salvation and grant us a willing spirit to sustain us. Holy Spirit, help us when we choose a side. As we enter 2021, as we choose a side, help us, Lord, to choose God's side for the rest of our lives. Help us to choose God's side for the rest of our lives. No in and out, in and out. No in and out. Choose God's side and stay there permanently for the rest of your life. Help us, Lord, in 2021. To use our time, our talent, our treasure to give glory to your name. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we appreciate you. Thank you for forgiving us of all our sins. This is a new year coming in. Lord, we thank you for your anointing upon us to do your will, for your anointing upon us to be led by the Holy Spirit, to follow God's direction for our lives, for our family, for our household, in every area of our lives. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Amen. God bless you. Very powerful. Glory to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Amen. Create us a cleaner to the Lord, renew the right spirit within us. Give us the attitude. You, when we are wrong, just like David did, and you forgive him. Thank you, Jesus. Mr. Jenny Taylor, God bless you, man.
Yes, sir. God bless you, Pastor. Thank God.
Yeah, encourage. Thank God for you.
Thank God for you. Glory to God. Such a mighty God. Amen. Amen. God is the Holy Spirit is such an excellent teacher. Amen. And we thank God for the year 2020. As I was preparing for this, God had been giving me things throughout the year, but what he impressed upon my heart was that year 2020 was the year of revelation. And God said 2020 revealed who you were in Christ. It revealed who and what was in you. It revealed our relationships, our motives, our intentions. It revealed idols. It revealed other gods, and it revealed our hearts. But God said in the year of 2021, be careful what you choose to be your God. Whatever you pursue becomes your God. So make sure whatever you're pursuing as your God, it can do whatever you need it to do. Said, what are you pursuing? David was a man after God's heart, but he was a man after God's heart because he pursued God. God said this year, 2021, there will be no plan B. And I said, God, plan B. And he said, yeah, plan B. For those of you who don't know, the plan B was a pill designed that a woman can take to stop the fertilization of the seed if she was to get pregnant. And God said plan B was designed to stop the seed from forming. Plan B stops fertilization. That's your heart, the soil, your heart. So God wants you to guard your heart. It prohibits growth in the grace, growing in the grace and the knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The plan B was designed to destroy the seed, and that was the word of God. So no plan Bs for 2021. God said in the year 20, we were interested, but we were not committed. And God said, when you're interested in something, you do it when it's convenient for you. But when you're committed, you do it regardless. So this will be the year of 2021 that we will not be interested, we'll be committed. God desires radical change this year. How will they see me? God said, when you are in the way. Radical change. The world needs to see me. God wants us to get bold this year. He said, if you be ashamed of me before men, I'll be ashamed of you before my Father in the name of Jesus. God doesn't want us just quoting scriptures. He wants us to live them. God said our mouths are divorced from our lifestyle, that we're saying one thing and we're doing others. We can't just read the book. We have to do the book in the name of Jesus. We can't be just addicted to songs and shouts and emotions. We have to be addicted to the word of God. Hallelujah. For the year 2021, in the name of Jesus, we have to get to know God for ourselves. We have to stop asking other people what they see. We have to see what God allows us to see. We have to stop asking people for what they see, what they know. Do you see what I see? What did God tell you? No. God said, press in this year. Get in and stay in. God says, I want your undivided attention in the name of Jesus. God said, for some people, you are the answer, but you don't know the answer because you won't seek me. This is the year of radical change in the name of Jesus. So, Lord, God said, I want 2021 to be the year of wholehearted commitment and surrender to his will and to his way. God said anything that could be shaken in 2020 was shaken. And anything that could stand, it stood in the name of Jesus. God said, stop picking what you like and pursue what you need. See, we might, I really don't like vegetables, but I know I need them. Because if I don't eat vegetables and if I don't eat things that causes me to grow, it stunts my growth. I won't be mature. I'll get bigger, but I won't have any power. So we need to stop pursuing what we like, picking what we like, and pursuing what we need. God said, God's church is not in trouble. Man's church is in trouble. And any church that has man and not God is God's church. It's man's church. So we thank you right now. The Lighted Path Christian Church International is God's church and not man's church. God's church is not in trouble. Man's church is in trouble. God wants us 2021 in the name of Jesus to be committed and not just interested in the name of Jesus. God said 2021 was the year, 2020 was the year of revelation. God allowed the pressing for the wine, not the whining. So God doesn't want us whining in 2021. He wants us to hold on and be unmovable, steadfast, always abounding in the work of the Lord. God said in 2021, turn up the light in the name of Jesus. Wherever you go, wherever God has placed you, wherever God has put you, you be the light. God said, what good is the lamp with no oil? It's just a lamp. But it won't serve its purpose with no oil in it. It's just a lamp. Help us this year in 2020 to be lamps with oil in it in the name of Jesus. Thank you that we will be lamps where the oil won't burn out in the name of Jesus. Thank you that this will be the year where we won't give up, where we're not tossed to and fro in the name of Jesus. God said in 2021, I'm not going to loosen up. I'm going to tighten up in the name of Jesus. So we thank you for the tightening up in 2021 in the name of Jesus. God decides if God is enough for us, and if God is not enough for us, then that's a sad decision for us. Decide God is enough, not God and something else. We have to go through the promise, the process to get through the promise. Some of us had to be processed in 2020. Some of us made up in our mind and some of us didn't. But 2021, we got to have a radical change. The world has to see God. God will pull us through if we can stand the pull. We might not like the message, but we better trust God's plan in the name of Jesus. God gave me this one last thing about a pregnancy test, and it was so powerful when I heard it. God said, faith is confidence in the without evidence. Faith is confidence without evidence. And God said, when I tell you something in my word, when I reveal something to you, I plan for you to do it and I want you to believe it. He said, when a woman takes a pregnancy test, all she gets is that positive signal on that test. If she takes it at the doctor's office or wherever, it's a positive test. And that woman right then knows that she is pregnant. And even before the baby comes, even before she realizes it's a boy or a girl, they buy clothes, they do a baby shower, they celebrate the baby before the baby gets here because they believe from that stick that they are having a baby. We need to believe the word of God when it goes forth. We need to believe that God will do what he promises it to do. We don't have to wait to see the ending because God said his word will never return void. God told me, Jenny, I'm married to my word. That means it will never come back fruitless. It will never come back without doing what I set it out to accomplish to do. So if we can believe a stick that says we're pregnant and we can go out and make all the preparations for the baby, help us to take this word of God that as it goes forth for the year of 2021, that we do all that is commanded for us to do, that we work in the vineyard, that we serve in the church, that we love wholeheartedly, that we are servants and loving God and loving God's people in the name of Jesus. So help us to put that word into practice. Help us to be like we are when we find out we're pregnant with a baby and all we got is a stick with a positive pregnancy test that says it's positive. Guess what? We got the word of God that never changes. As long as seed time and harvest time remain, the word of God will never return void. The word of God will always do what it set out to do. The word of God is for sure and we can hold on to it because God says, I'm not a man who should lie, nor the son of man who needs to repent. If I said it, that settles it. So thank you, Lord God, for 2021 being the year of radical change for your people in the name of Jesus. Again, I have come in agreement with Sister Minister Marina Kay and Pastor Ogeni that we take an inventory of our life and those times where we were not with God and not walking with God and walking contrary to the word of God and pursuing other gods and pursuing people and pursuing fame and pursuing our own desires, that we lay all of that to the side and that we pursue God, that we be God chasers in the year 2021. Radical change for your people, God. We love you, we adore you, and we appreciate you. Amen.
Glory be to God in the highest, and so powerful. Hallelujah. We praise his holy name. God's people, we taking notes. God's name speaking. Oh my goodness. Be a really wonderful year. Thank you, man. Thank you. Amen. You be encouraged. Keep the faith. Amen. That's a double header right there. Well, thank God we have now, Mr. Malloyd. To take the floor. God bless you, sir.
Hey, God bless you too. Praise God for you. Can you hear me okay? I was hearing a little feedback earlier, but I'm assuming you can hear me. Hallelujah.
Loud and clear, sir. Loud and clear.
Glory be to God for his grace. Hallelujah. It's an interesting thing. God begins to share with us, and he just kind of ties everything in together because he's great, and he's marvelous, and he's wonderful, and he's all-knowing, and he's involved in his people's lives if we allow him to be involved. Just a few scriptures for you. Malachi 3, chapter 3, verse 3. 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 7. Daniel chapters 3 and chapter 6, very familiar to most of us. James chapter 1. Verses 1 through 5, Mark chapter 13, verse 22, Matthew chapter 24, verses 22 through 24. I mean, you could read the whole chapter of both of those, 13 and 24, just kind of give you an idea of what God is expressing to us. And then Zechariah chapter 13. Zechariah chapter 13, verse 1, it says, on that day a fountain will be opened to the house of David and the inhabitants of Jerusalem to cleanse them from sin and impurity. I'd like to also draw your attention when you talk about 1 Corinthians chapter 6, verse 9, because he talks about, and such were some of you, but you've been washed, you've been sanctified, you've been justified, all in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ and by the Holy Spirit. And so, and then Zechariah 13 and 9, this third I will bring in to the fire. I will refine them like silver and test them like gold. I have to let you know that testing and refining are two different processes. When you're testing something, you're checking it out to prove that it's authentic, that it is what it's supposed to be, and whatever it says it is and is going to be, and it is that. Through the test, you find out, hey, that's exactly what it is. And the type of test used will have an indication or a certain reaction that verifies that, yeah, that is exactly what it is. If it's gold and they use a certain test on it, that test will verify that, yes, that is gold. Indeed is gold. It's not fake gold. It's not fool's gold. It's not plated gold, but it's real gold. And there's a series of tests that you have to get to that some things you can do at home, for instance. You can do them all at home, some of these tests, but it's not really reliable until you actually take it into someone who knows for a fact this is their profession. This is what they're trained to do. This is what they have skill to do, to recognize fake gold from real gold. They can determine the character of the gold. They can determine the carat of the gold, and they can probably even tell you where the gold came from. And so what that is for us is the Lord. And he takes us through various trials in our lives so that he can prove that our faith is genuine to him. It's 1 Peter 1 and 7. Glory to God. 1 Peter 1 and 7. Where he says, and I'll read 6 through 7, says, in this you greatly rejoice, though now for a little while, if need be, you have been grieved by various trials, that the genuine of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perishes, though it is tested by fire, may be found to praise, honor, and glory at the revelation of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen, you love. Though now you do not see him, yet believing, you rejoice with joy inexpressible and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, the salvation of your souls. And so God has to, once again, test our faith. He has to test our faith to see if it's genuine, because our faith is more precious than gold. How do we know that? God gave us a witness. He gave us a witness in Daniel chapter 3. As you remember, Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they would not bow down to the image of gold. And so once again, we see gold showing up. Gold is precious to man. It might be valuable to men, but it's something that God has created. God is more concerned about man's faith. He says, without faith, it's impossible to please him. For those that come to him must believe he is, and a reward of those that diligently seek him. So what we find out is that God just doesn't accept anybody coming to him. You have to be tested. Your faith has to be proven. Your faith has to be shown that it's genuine in order to be able to go where God wants us to go, to show up where God wants us to show up, to be who God wants us to be. If you say you're a Christian and God says, okay, you're a Christian, then you have to go through this test. You have to go through this trial. You have to go through this difficulty in order to say if you're a Christian. You just can't wear that like it's some kind of T-shirt you can take off and put on anytime you want to. No, it has to be in your heart. It has to be in our DNA. We have to be who we are because Christ shed his blood, and the blood is DNA material. And that DNA material tells you exactly what this child is going to be or what this human being is going to be. And so the DNA determines what you're going to look like when you start to grow, what kind of features you're going to have, whether you're going to have blue eyes, brown eyes, purple eyes, green eyes, whether you're going to be tall or short, you know, what color of skin you're going to have. The DNA determines all of that. And so if we're talking about that we're blood bought and we're washed and we're cleansed and we belong to God, then there's a certain character that we should have. And so Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego said to Nebuchadnezzar, actually they said, oh, Nebuchadnezzar, we have no need to answer you in this matter. If that is the case, our God, whom we serve, is able to deliver us from the burning fiery furnace, and he will deliver us from your hand, O king. But if not, let it be known to you, O king, that we do not serve your gods, nor will we worship the gold image that you have set up. And so if our faith is more precious than gold, then here it is demonstrated that our faith outlasts gold. Gold is going to perish when the earth perishes, because everything is reserved for fire and judgment. But God says that our faith should not perish. Our faith should be imperishable, because these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Faith worketh by love. So it's all entangled in there together. There's no separation between faith, hope, and love, because we hope for something that we haven't yet received. We're talking about here, the goal of our faith is the salvation of our souls. And so as you go through difficulties in life, he says, don't fear the one who can kill the body, but the one who can take the body and the soul and cast them into hell. And so what are we going to do at this personal, at this particular point in time in 2021 and 2020? What are we going to do in this particular point in time as God begins to test, as God begins to show up, as God begins to purify us? Once again, he says, I will bring in Zechariah 13:9, I will bring one third through the fire. And so if you know anything about fractions, one third is one part of two other parts. And so we're talking about there's supposed to be three thirds to make a whole. And so out of that, God says he's going to take one third, because the two thirds are going to fall by the wayside. He says two thirds of it and it will be cut off and die, but one third shall be left in it. And so God is not really concerned about how we feel as we serve him. He's more concerned about who we belong to and whether or not we match up with what we say we are and who we say we are during this time. So as the persecution comes, what are you going to do? Are you going to give up? Are you going to falter? Are you going to faint? He says repeatedly that there will be a time even where God's elect, and that's in Matthew 24 and Mark 13. He says in verse 23, he says, if anyone says to you, look, here's the Christ, or there, do not believe it. For false Christs and false prophets will arise and show great signs and wonders to deceive, if possible, even the elect. Now, the elect don't have to be deceived. Glory to God. I hear a lot of people saying this, and they say it as if the elect going to be deceived. No, the elect don't have to be deceived. You don't have to be deceived when you decide that you want to have a genuine relationship with God. That means that you're going to count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of our faith produces patience, and allow patience to have its perfect work, so we might be complete, entire, lacking nothing. Many of us are lacking a lot of things simply because we're not adding to our faith. We heard that last week. We need to add to our faith. Faith just can't stand by itself. Faith needs some help. I said faith needs some help. We need to add to our faith, and we need to add to our faith that goodness and that self-control and the knowledge and the things that we learned last week. I got to go there. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. 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 And that's 2 Peter chapter 1. Glory be to God. Thank God for his grace. We thank God for his grace. I'm going to be wrapping up here. He says, but also for this reason, hallelujah. What was this reason? Because he said, for this reason, he wants us. He says, because we're partakers of his divine nature, we can escape the corruption that is in the world through lust. And so what's the one thing we have to look out? We have to look out for lust. He's not just talking about lust for sex, but lust for money, lust for pride, lust for power, lust for unforgiveness, lust for bitterness, lust for anger, lust for rage, lust for malice, lust for sympathy, lust for wanting to feel like woe is me. All the kind, lust for depression, lust for anxiety, lust for fear. All those things that we lust after because we want to hold on to our flesh. That's the lust that we want to hold on to our flesh. But also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge, to knowledge self control, to self control perseverance, to perseverance godliness, to godliness brotherly kindness, to brotherly kindness, love. For if these things are yours and abound, you will neither be barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. For he who lacks these things is short-sighted, even to blindness, and has forgotten that he's been cleansed from our old sins. So let go of that. I said let go of that, because he said, therefore we be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you'll never stumble. And so thanks be to God that this year, as we go through trials and we go through tests and we go through difficulties, that we hold on and we allow our faith to be tested. But as you're going through, if you don't count it all joy, you're going to miss the mark. You're not going to mature nor grow up or become what God is testing you to become. He says he tests us so that we may be authentic Christians, and then he refines us so that we can shine like stars in the midst of a crooked and perverse generation as we hold out the word of life. Hallelujah. But you got to do things without arguing and complaining. No arguing and complaining this year. Hallelujah. Be thankful. Be thankful unto God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, sir. God bless you, Mr. My Lord. A very, very powerful session. Thank you, Jesus. Is worthy to be praised. Minister Jenny Taylor, if you don't mind, I want to have it to just lead us, just sing hallelujah, you know. Hallelujah, hallelujah, we need it.
Amen.
God kept us throughout the entire year, so just kind of help us with that.
Hallelujah.
Okay, Lord, we praise you. Lord, praise us with this.
Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Lord, we thank you. 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 Lord, we love 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 you. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you.
Amen. God bless you. Glory be to God in the highest, on earth, peace be unto all men. On whom his favor rests. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. We worship you today. We love you today. We appreciate you today. Lord, you are the Alpha and Omega. You are the first and the last. You are the beginning and the end. You are the bright morning star. You are the root of Jesus. You are the offspring of David. You are the Lamb of the tribe of Judah. You are the one that says, it's I, don't be afraid. Lord, we thank you. Coming here, we dedicate this upcoming year to you, Lord. We say, Lord, you're able to keep back this committed to you. We commit our life to you. Thank you for the strong anointing of God in our life. Thank you for the grace of God in our life today, Lord. And Father, we just thank you. We worship you. We love you. We appreciate you. And Lord, we thank you, Lord, that we have a faith in the Lord Jesus Christ and we have a love for God's people today. And Lord, we thank you. We have not stopped giving thanks to God. This is Ephesians chapter 1, verse 15 and 16. Thank you, Lord, we are not stopped giving thanks to you, Lord, for each other, remembering each other in prayer. We keep asking that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the glorious Father, may give us, Lord, the spirit of wisdom. Lord, we thank you that the power of the Spirit, give us the spirit of wisdom, Lord, and revelation, and so that we may know you better. Lord, we want to know you better this coming year. And the children of Israel knew your acts, but Moses knew your way. We want to know your way this upcoming year. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Lord, for your grace today, Lord. We thank you. We pray that the eyes of the understanding of how to be enlightened and know you better. Amen. For we know the hope for which you have called us, riches of your glorious grace, and Father, we just thank you for that great power for us, who can also believe. That power is the same as the mighty strength. He is that when he raised Christ from the dead and sent him at the right hand of God in heavenly realms, far above rule and authority and power and dominion. Lord, we thank you. That's wonderful. Lord, that's beautiful beyond compare. Lord, throughout this entire year, Lord, help us not to focus on our past, Lord. Forget those things which are behind. And press not to those things which are before. We press not to the lack of a high calling of Christ Jesus in our life. Thank you for Philippians chapter 3, verse 12. It's not that I've already obtained all this, or I've already arrived at my goal. The Lord needs to let us know, and we need to also know, that we have not arrived. We are not perfect people. We are in progress. I'm confident of this very thing. He which has begun the good work in you is faithful to complete it. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you for your presence, Lord. Yeah, this is Philippians chapter 3, verse 12. Not that I've already obtained all this, I've already arrived at my goal, but I press to take hold of that for which Christ Jesus took a hold of me. Hey, God save us by His Spirit. He tagged us. He said, I need to find out why He tagged me. I need to find out why He saved me. That's a revelation right there. I need to go after him. He went after me, tagged me, you know, saved me. I need to find out why he saved me. Finding out why he saved me with my appetite to go after God. Amen. As you have found after the brooks of waters, my soul panted for you, Lord, for the living God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Not that I have already obtained all this, but I press on to take hold for that which Christ Jesus took a hold of me. Brothers and sisters, I do not consider myself blessed to have taken hold of it, but this one thing I do, forgetting what is behind and straining towards what is ahead, I press towards the goal to win the prize for which God has called me heavenward in Christ Jesus. All of us then who are mature should say, take us a few of things. Get not to forgive yourself in this year. And to say, Lord, you know something? Forgive me. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you. All my people take such a few of things, and someone at one point think differently. God will make it clear to you. Let us hold on to what we have already attained. Dear Lord, glory be to God. who come to Lord in the holy name of Jesus, come to give the glory and the praise and the honor. So we thank you, Lord, we love you, Lord, we appreciate you. And Lord, God, for this upcoming year, we want to bring it in with a thanksgiving. God, we enter the day with thanksgiving, and we enter your court with praise. So we are full unto you and bless your holy name. For the Lord is good, and your mercy endureth forever. The truth endureth to all generations. For the Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, we know we can depend on you today. The name of the Lord is a strong power. The righteous one is raised and they are saved. We thank you for every member of the Christian Church International. Thank you for every death and every member of our family. We lift them up to you today. The word said, you're able to keep that which is committed to you. This upcoming year, Lord, help us to be obedient. This upcoming year, Lord, help us to become lesser. And you might become greater until Christ is fully formed in us. This upcoming year, Lord, help us to serve the poor of God my generation. And help us not to yield to temptation, but to yield to you. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Lord, I thank you for your anointing. Thank you for your strong presence in our life. For sin shall not rule over us, because I'm not under the law, but under grace. This is Romans chapter 6. Lord, what shall we say? Shall we go on sinning that grace may increase by no means? Father, we thank you that this upcoming year, I will not go on. Keep on sinning, but we're going to move away from sin and allow the Holy Spirit to live his life through us. And Father, we just thank you. Help us prepare to serve this cup coming year that Christ might live his life through us. For I'm crucified with Christ already. The life that I now live is yet not I, but it's Christ that liveth in me. And the grace that I use is the grace of the Son of God that loved me and gave himself for me. And Lord, we thank you for your presence.
Jesus.
Thank you for your anointing. And Lord, we thank you. Romans chapter 6, verse 11. In the same way, God has served with death to sin, but alive to God in Christ Jesus. Lord, I thank you that we offer ourselves, Lord, as a living sacrifice to you today. We cast ourselves to be dead unto sin. Lord, throughout this entire year, create in us a clean heart today. May not be right through within us. Let our attitude be right towards God and the fellow men. Let the joy of the Lord be our strength. And Lord, as we find ourselves not to resist the Holy Spirit, but to comply, but to yield to you, to surrender to you, Lord, you are the Almighty God, you are the one that began the good work in us. Hallelujah, and you are faithful to complete it. The Lord is to follow you out of your pure heart today. Call on God out of your pure heart by the power of the Spirit in the holy name of Jesus. Lord, we thank you. We worship you. We love you, Lord. We appreciate you. Thank you, Lord, for Romans chapter 6, verse 13. Do not offer any part of yourself to sin as instrument of wickedness. And Lord, we spend enough time in our own wickedness. We repent, Lord. We turn away from our wicked ways and turn towards you. From this time on, Lord, you own us. You purchase us with your own blood. Spirit, soul, and body, we belong to God. Do not know that your body is the temple of your Holy Spirit, which we are of God. We are not our own. Therefore, glorify God in our body and our spirit that belong to God. Lord, I thank you. We bring it to our realization that our body belongs to you, our mind belongs to you, our soul belongs to you, our spirit belongs to you. Every part of our life belongs to you. We are purchasing food on the cross of Calvary with the blood of Jesus. Oh, Father, we thank you.
Yes, Lord.
Love you, Lord. Mm-hmm. And Lord, we thank you for Romans 6:14. For sin shall no longer be your master, because you are not under the law but under sin. Lord, help us to cooperate with you. Be dead unto sin, but to be alive in Christ this upcoming year. Lord, we love you. Lord, we appreciate you.
Amen.
Lord, we lift up your holy name today, for you alone is worthy. Thank you, Lord, for such an honor to be our master, for we are not under the love, but under grace. Lord, we thank you for your anointing that rests upon us. Thank you for the grace of God and salvation for us today. Thank you that we are more than conquerors. We are bodily and not beneath. We are the head and not the tail. And Lord, throughout this entire year, help us come to the realization that you are God. We need to pray to us. When we pray, you answer, because we made a way through the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for the holy, strong anointing. Thank you for the awesome presence of God in our life today. Thank you for the grace of God that is sufficient for us. And Father, we just thank you that we won't quit, we won't give up, we won't give him, we won't put our hope in God. For the name of the Lord is a strong power. That is a strong truth, and they are saved. Thank you for every member of the Pakistan Church International. That we seek your face, that we hear from you clearly, and we'll be obedient to you from the beginning of the year to the end of the year and beyond. Thank you. Help us to be pleasing unto you. Let the words of our mouth, Lord, and the meditation of our heart be acceptable in your sight. O Lord, that strengthen our Redeemer. Let our prayer come to you as like a sacrifice, Lord, like an incense coming to your nursery. And Lord, we just thank you. We worship you, Lord. We love you, Lord. We appreciate you. Lord, you are God. Lord, you are holy. Lord, you are righteous. Lord, you are wonderful. Lord, you are beautiful beyond compare, Lord. There's none like you in heaven. It's not like you on earth. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Psalm 141. He said, I call to you, Lord. Come quickly to me. Hear our prayer when we call to you. May our prayer be set before you like incense. May the lifting up of our hands be like in the sacrifice. Set a guard on our mouth, over our mouth, Lord, and keep watch over the door of our lips. Do not let our heart be drawn to what is evil. Throughout this entire 2021 year, we pray in the name of Jesus by the power of the Spirit that our heart will not be drawn to what is evil, so that we take part in wicked deeds and with those who are evildoers. Do not let us in their delicacies. Let the righteous man strike me, Lord, and not be a kindness. Let him rebuke me, it will be a thought in my head. And Father, we just thank you. We worship you. We love you. We appreciate you. Our eyes is focused on you today, Lord. You are the sovereign Lord. And Lord, we thank you. This is verse 8. Our eyes are focused on you, Lord. You are the sovereign Lord. We take a refuge in you. Do not give us over to death. Keep us safe from the trials of the evildoers. And Father, we thank you. From the snares that they have laid up for us, let the wicked fall into their own nest, or we will pass by in safety. Lord, we thank you. Lord, we love you. Lord, help us to have a heart of God today. Help us to have a heart for you today, Lord. Because you see, you are a heart God. Man look on the outer of the appearance, but God look in the heart. When you look in our heart, Lord, let the words of our mouth and the meditation of our heart be acceptable in your sight. Oh, Lord, our strength and our redeemer. You are God. You are holy. You are righteous. You are wonderful. Lord, we worship you. Lord, we love you. Lord, we magnify your name. Help us to come to maturity in our walk with you. Help us not to go by what we see, but to go by what God says. Lord, we are good with God today. We are more than conqueror. Above all, I am not here today. Here is another deal. And Father, we just thank you. We are good with you today. Our fungus shall prosper. Help us to look up to the hills. Where help coming from? Our help come from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Lord, we thank you. We worship you. We love you today. Look for Psalm 121. So I lift up my heart to the hills. Amen. Where does our help come from? Our help come from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. Lord, help us always look up to you, not to ever forget that we have you. The Bible says, God before us, who can be against us? If I did not spare, only begotten Son, but have him deliver for us all. Actually, let us pray to him, give us all things. Lord, this coming year, help us not to neglect our fellowship with you in prayer. Help us to come boldly to the throne of grace. But we have not the high priest that cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities, but was at all points tempted as we are, but yet without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace and find the grace of help in times of need. But we thank you this new year, Lord. At midnight, we are going to be shooting and doing all kinds of everything in celebration, but we soak ourselves in prayer. And I thank you for your divine safety. I thank you for your blanket of protection for every member and every person under the sound of my voice. That we are divinely protected by God. We are not afraid. God has not given us the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Normally, we do this at the church, but we are having the church in the home today. Lord, I thank you for protecting your own. Be able to keep that which is committed to you. And Lord, I thank you for protecting every member and every guest and every person under the sound of my voice. That we are divinely protected by God. It has not fallen at our side, it has not at our right, but shall not come near us, but shall give the angels charge over us. Lord, you are God. Lord, you are holy. Lord, you are righteous. Oh, hallelujah. We worship you, Lord. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you for your grace, Lord. Thank you for your peace, Lord. Thank you for the yoke, the strength, and nothing of God, Lord. Thank you for showing yourself strong in every area of our life today, Lord. And Father, we thank you. Lift up our eyes to the hills, Lord. Where does our help come from? Our help come from the Lord, by the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let our foot slip. Lord, I thank you for fastening our foot, Lord, making us out, Lord, keeping us, Lord. He watches over us, knowing that we will not slumber. Lord, you don't slumber because you don't go to sleep. You are a spirit. Hallelujah. You don't slumber. He watches over Israel, or he watches over the Pakistan church, national families. We will never slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over us, Lord. The Lord is our shield at our right hand, in the holy name of the Lord. I thank you. The sun will not harm us by day, but the moon by night. The Lord will keep us from all harm. The Lord will watch over our life. The Lord will watch over our coming and going, both now and forevermore. Lord, keep us. Lord, lead us. Lord, guide us. Lord, direct us. Lord, empower us. And Father, we thank you, Lord. Help us to stay with you all the way, Lord. Help us not to ever depart from you. And Father, we just thank you. We worship you, Lord. Holy Spirit, you are God. Holy Spirit, you are so awesome. And there's an awesome presence in this place among us today. Oh, Lord, you are so wonderful. Lord, you are so beautiful beyond compare. That the Almighty God, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, Lord, you are God today, Lord. Make a difference in our life forever. Help us not to preach in the midst of our testimony. Help us to depend on God in every area. And Father, we just thank you. Just let me to Genesis chapter 5, Lord. Verse 21. When Enoch had lived 65 years, he became the father of Methuselah. After he became the father of Methuselah, Enoch walked faithfully with God for 300 years and had sons and daughters. 365 years of his life to walk with God. From the day he was 65 years old when he turned to walk with God. Before this, they lived and died. All of a sudden, he got to Enoch. I thank you for the power of your spirit that every member of the Practice Church International will walk with you. I will not go back. Enoch did not go back. He walked with God 300 years. He was 65 years old when he met God. And from that time on, the Bible says Enoch walked with God. And then there was no more Enoch but God. The Lord moved him. The Lord took him. And he was not buried. He didn't have to see any death. Because when you go to my house now, just come on in this way. Hallelujah. Enoch was not buried because God took him. So he had a testimony that he pleased God. And without faith, it's impossible to please God. Help not to be like a yo-yo, not go back and forth between God and the evil. Able to stick with it like a glue and stay there for Enoch. As an Old Testament man, he walked with God for 300 years. No backsliding, no back nothing. Let me read it again. Genesis chapter 5, Genesis 5:21. When Enoch had lived 65 years old, he became the father, hallelujah, of Methuselah. After he became the father of Methuselah, Enoch walked faithfully with God. God help us this coming year to walk faithfully with every member of the Practice of Church International. Help us walk faithfully. Help us walk faithfully, Lord, for the faithful issue is faithful. Lord, I thank you that we have every reason to walk with you. When there are no alternatives, when we know there are no alternatives, then I walk with the Holy Spirit. Thank you for your presence, Lord. Thank you for your grace, Lord. And Father, we thank you. Enough of God, help us to be faithful to you all the days of our life, not to ever quit, not to ever give up, but to grow in grace and the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we thank you for every member, thank you for every household today. Keep us, Lord. Lead us, Lord. Guide us, Lord. Empower us, Lord. Let the anointing rest upon our life. Let the practice of protection of God be upon our life. In every days of our life, Lord, we thank you. I'll be shooting to celebrate my milk and beers and wine and champagne to celebrate, but we celebrate with a new wine. It's called the Holy Spirit. They are so wonderful. They are beautiful beyond compare. We worship the Lord. We love you, Lord. We appreciate you today. Enough of God. There was no more enough with God. And we just thank you. They are so wonderful. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With my head lifted up today and my heart filled with praise, with the heart of thanksgiving, I will bless you, O Lord. We bless your holy name today. Bless the wonderful name of Jesus. No other name I know. Hallelujah. Bless you, wonderful name. We appreciate the Lord. We magnify your name, Lord. We lift up your name today. But you are so wonderful. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Let's go close to the midnight. I'm going to pick it off with Psalm 136. It says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for you are good and your love endures forever. Lord, we give you thanks. Lord, we give you praise. Lord, we give you honor today. And Lord, you are God. You are worthy of all the praises. For you are worthy, O Lord, to receive the glory and the honor and the wisdom and the power and the praise and the dominion forever and ever. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are God. Lord, you are awesome. Hallelujah. Make a difference in our life forever. Let the one who will be with Jesus. You are the Alpha and the Omega. You are the first and the last. You are the beginning and the end. You are the bright morning star. You are the root of Jesse. You are the offspring of David. You are the Lord of the tribe of Judah. You are the one that was and is and is to come. You are the ancient of days. Hallelujah. Rock of ages. Hallelujah. You are wonderful. You are all powerful. You are all knowing. You know all things. You can do all things. You are omnipotent. All powerful. You are omnipresent, you are in every place. You are omniscient, you know all things. Lord, never catch you by surprise. Lord, we thank you. You are the Almighty God. We appreciate you, Lord. We magnify your name today. Oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. We sought the Lord and he had us and deliver from all our fears. Oh, test and say that the Lord is good. I can hear you. Man, keep his word pure and living according to your word. We thank you for this upcoming year that we live according to your word. Lord, create us again as today. We know the right spirit within us. Father, we thank you for the strength to go with God all the way. Holy Spirit, you are God. Help us not to ignore the Holy Spirit. Empower us, Lord. We shall be filled with the Holy Spirit. And after you fill with the Holy Spirit, we shall be my witnesses in Jerusalem, Judea, Samaria, to the uttermost part of the earth. Lord, I thank you. Be able to keep that which is committed to you throughout this entire year. I pray that every member of the Practice Church International and our guests and our family keep us, we want to be kept. Lead us, we want to be led. Guide us, we want to be guided. And Lord, empower us. Empower us. Let the one who have been with Jesus know that fungus shall prosper. Hallelujah. Glory to your name today. Glory be to your name today. Lord God Almighty, we give you praise. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord for your good and your mercy and your loving kindness and endure forever. Lord, you are the God of God, you are the King of Kings. Oh, give thanks to the God of God for your good and your mercy and your loving kindness and endure forever. Oh, give thanks to the Lord of Lords, you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, for you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness and endure forever. So you alone, the Almighty God, the maker of heaven and earth, it must be wonders, for you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. So you alone, who by your understanding made the heavens, for you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. So you made the heavens and you made the earth and everything else, visible and invisible. All things are made for you, and without you was nothing made that was made. For you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. So you spread out the earth upon the waters, Lord, for you are good. And your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace, Lord. Thank you, Lord, you are a good God. Everything that you made, you said they are good. And Lord, thank you. And thank you.
Thank you, Jesus.
You did not die to do good. You died to only get to believe. Thank you, Jesus. We're not trying to catch up the whole creation. We are a new creation in Christ. Help us to act like the Lord. Help us to see the advantage of us being a new creation. We agree with God today. Live your life through today, Lord. We yield to you. We give you the right of way. Thank you for the access that we have to the throne of grace. For we have not the high priest that cannot be touched with the feelings of our infirmities. So at all points, tempted as we are, be here without sin. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace that we find the grace to help in terms of no, we need the grace. Father, abundance of grace on your people, Lord, throughout this entire year. Let your grace be sufficient for us, Lord. Answer every prayer. Fulfill every desire of our heart this coming year. And Lord, we thank you that we have no lack this upcoming year. Father, we thank you that we stand firm in our work to do this upcoming year. Father, we thank you that we become blessed and you have become greater and the Christ is fully formed in us throughout this coming year. In the holy name of Jesus, Lord, I thank you for the access that we have to the throne of grace. Let every member press in, Lord. Let every member come from the outer court to the Holy of the Holies and stay in the Holy of the Holies. Let every member have the gumption, have the tenacity not to quit on you, but to give up on you. And Father, we just thank you. So we thank you, Lord. Oh, thank you, Lord. So we thank you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. You are the one that made the great light, Lord. For you are good and your mercy endure forever. So you made the sun to govern the day. For you are good and your loving kindness endure forever. Lord, I thank you. The men that will catch us worshiping God and praising God. Oh, give thanks to this King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. For you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. Lord, you made the moon and the stars to go over the night. For you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. You destroyed the firstborn of Egypt. For you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. You are the Almighty God, you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And Lord, we thank you. We worship you. We magnify your name. We lift up your holy name. We brought out Israel from among them, Lord, for you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. With your mercy and an outstretched arm, Lord, for you are good and your mercy and your loving kindness endure forever. So you that divide the Red Sea asunder in the flood stage, Lord, you said it's still full. And that's why you divide the Red Sea. Because you see, whether it's trusted or not, nobody can stop a God from doing what he wants to do, whenever I want to do it. Whatever door you open, no man can close. Whatever door you close, no man can open. Thank you for your good and your shame. Thank you. You are for us today. God is saying, I'm with you, I'm for you, I'm never leaving or forsake you. You belong to me, and I belong to you. Stand firm. Stand firm in your faith. Don't quit on me. Don't give up on me. With something that's impossible, but not with God. If I say something, will not be to pass. I'm the Almighty God. I never leave you nor forsake you. I'm with you throughout the entire situation. I will never leave you nor forsake you. Trust in me. Put your hope in me. Depend on me. Pray to me. And when you pray like you have a backbone. Pray like you're not going to answer your prayer. Because I promise I will never leave you nor forsake you. I promise you belong to me and I belong to you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everyone who's ever put in the midst of a testimony. Lord, divided the rest of your son, for you are good and your mercy endure forever. You brought Israel out through the midst of it, for you are good and your mercy endure forever. You said, Pharaoh and Israel coming to the Red Sea, for you are good and your mercy endure forever. Lord, you led your people through the wilderness. Lord, thank you. Thank you, Lord, for leading your people through the wilderness, for you are good and your mercy endure forever. So in the story of the great kings, for you are good, and your mercy and loving kindness endure forever. And kill mighty kings, for you are good, and your mercy and loving kindness endure forever. Because he's saying it again, I never leave you nor forsake you. Trust in me this year. Don't quit on me. Develop a personal relationship. So until that offer, don't quit, because you know who you believe. Hallelujah. I know whom I believe, and God is able to keep those that commit to him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You kill mighty kings, for you are good. And your mercy endure forever. Psalm King of the Amorites, you are good, and your mercy endure forever. Say hallelujah, and all King of Bashan, for you are good, and your mercy endure forever. Give the land as an inheritance, for you are good, and your mercy endure forever. And answer to your servant Israel, for you are good, and your mercy endure forever. Lord, you remember us in our lowest state, Lord. You are the Almighty God. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You know all things, Lord. You can do all things, Lord. We depend on you today. In the name of the Lord, this is from power, the righteous run through it, and they ask it. Help us not to quit on you. Help us not to give up, Lord. Hallelujah. It does not stand firm. We will not stand at all if you don't stand firm in your faith. And Lord, this entire year, when the Son of Man comes, shall they find faith on the planet? Lord, thank you that you find faith with us, that we're going to hold on to you. We'll never give up. We won't give up. We won't give in. We'll put our hope in you. Thank you, Jesus, for your good. Your mercy endure forever. Thank you, Lord, for freeing us from all our enemies. For you are good, and your mercy endure forever. Lord, thank you for giving food to every creature, including every member of the Baptist Church in France and others like this. For you are good, and your mercy endure forever. Oh, give thanks to the God of heaven, that the Almighty God, that our protector, that our God, that our King, that our deliverer. Oh, Father, we have appetite, Lord. Help us have a strong appetite to go with God all the way this year. Help us not to quit on you. Help us to depend on you today. In the name of the Lord is a strong power. The righteous run through it and they are saved. Thank you for your presence today, Lord. And Lord, we're going to use our mouth to complain this year. We're going to use our mouth to praise you. I will magnify the, oh, magnify the Lord with me. Let us adopt your name together. Hallelujah. I will get the Lord at all times. Your praise shall continually be in my mouth. Oh, thank you, Lord, for some carry for today.
Jesus.
We worship you, Lord. We love you, Lord. Hallelujah. I will bless the Lord at all times. Your praise shall continually be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the affliction hear and rejoice. Glorify God below with me. Let us exalt his name together. We sought the Lord and the answer us and deliver from all our fears. Those who look in my radiance and their faces are never covered with shame. Lord, we look up to you this year, Lord. Those who look to you are radiant and our faces are never covered with shame because we put our trust in you. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, you are so wonderful. Thank you for your awesome presence in our midst, Lord. Thank you for the yoke, the strength, and anointing. The body shall be removed from the shoulder. The yoke shall be destroyed to the anointing. We belong to you, Lord. We depend on you today, Lord. In the name of the Lord is a strong power. I just run through it and they are saved. Lord, you are God all by yourself. You see the room between the cherubim. You are the Almighty God. You are the all powerful God. You are the all knowing God. You alone is worthy. For everlasting, you are God. You are the Rock of Ages. You are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. You are the Christ Minister. You are the Root of Jesse. You are the offspring of David. You are the Lamb itself. We worship you today. We magnify your name today. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. Holy. Holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, which was and is to come. Heaven and earth are filled with your glory. How great thou art today. You are the Almighty God, and the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Oh, test and see that the Lord is good today. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Fear the Lord is his holy people. For those who fear him, lack nothing. Young man, be cold and hungry. But those who seek the Lord will never make any good thing. Come, my children, listen to me, and I will teach you the fear of the Lord. Whoever loves life and desires to see many good things, keep your tongue from evil and your lips from telling lies. Tongue from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. For the eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and the ears are open, attending to their cry. For the face of the Lord is against those who do evil, to blot them out on put out their name on the face of the earth. Just cry out, and the Lord hears them and deliver them from all their trouble. Hallelujah. The Lord is close to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in the spirit. The righteous person may have many troubles, but the Lord delivers out of it all. King Jesus, and we worship today. People will slay the wicked. Amen. The healthy Paul is born, not one of this is broken. But people will slay the wicked, but the foes of the righteous will be condemned. The Lord will rescue his servant. No one who takes refuge in the Lord will be condemned. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. You are so wonderful today. Beautiful beyond compare today. Hallelujah. Lord is saying right now, he said, I don't want to walk in between two opinions. Make up my mind this year. If I'm going to walk with God, if the Lord is going to walk with him, not leave me alone. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Don't just bring the pain. Amen. The Lord was letting me know. So we have a tendency to lean towards the flesh or to lean towards, to default towards what we know when we're in trouble. But I don't want to default towards anything else. Default towards God. Default towards God. Default towards God. Put your hope in God. Depend on him. Default towards God. Default towards God. Hallelujah. Don't default in anything. Default towards God. Don't give up. Don't give up on God. 1 Kings chapter 18, verse 21. And Elijah came up to all the people and said, how long will you hold between two opinions? If the Lord is the God, follow him. If he be bad, then follow him. And the people answer him, not a word. Nobody didn't answer me with a word because they want to do both. They want to do both. Because I don't want you doing both this year. I want you to love righteousness and hate iniquity this year. Hallelujah. Don't bring a disgrace to my name this year. Make up your mind. I will keep you if you want to be kept. I will watch you by you. I answer your prayer. I will fulfill the desires of your heart. I will set you up along the plan I have for your life if you follow me this year. This year is a year of persecution, so expect a lot of persecution. But at the same time, it's a year of major victory. A whole lot of things that you have been living in God for will come to pass this year in a hurry, because you're living in the last of the last days. And God is not the man that should laugh, also not the man that should repent. If I were you, I make up my mind to remain faithful all the way, to remain faithful to be like Enoch, who walked with God for 300 years. He was 65 years old when he met God. And the Bible says he walked with God. Before that, if you look at genealogy and the lived and they die, and they live, and they die, and they live, and all of them get to Enoch. So wait a minute, I cannot walk with God. And before the Lord took him, he had a testimony that he pleased God. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. For it that come to him of good that he is, and it's a reward of them that diligently seek him. Oh, glory be to God. That's your holy name today, Lord. That's chapter 18, verse 21, 1 Kings 18, 21. They say, I'm going to support this into your opinion. So God is saying, don't do that this year. But I want you to walk by faith and not by sight this year. I want you to depend on me. Hallelujah. Don't go by what you feel. Go by what I say. Hallelujah. He said, do you know that the integrity of God? Do you know the integrity of God? But one thing to ask you, do you know the integrity of God? Do you know that God has integrity? Hallelujah. And if you know that, then act like it. Amen. Act like it. Go like it. Like you know that integrity. Hallelujah. But if you don't do that, then you're going to be in trouble. If you don't do that, then it's difficult to trust a person that you don't know their ability. Because I have a great ability that my people don't even know I have. And so because of that, they relate to me as if I don't have enough power to help them. And that's a sad indictment. The Almighty God, the Ancient of Days, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, you say, that's not as if they have no power to help you. Because people know his ways, but they know his act, but they don't know his ways. Let me share something with you here. Hallelujah. He said, you know the integrity of God. 2 Timothy chapter 1, verse 11. Hallelujah. And 12. And of this gospel I was appointed a herald and an apostle. This is what Paul is saying. And this is why I'm suffering as I am. Yet there is no cause for shame, because I know whom I have believed. I'm convinced that he's able to guard that which I entrust to him on the bad day. Paul is saying, I'm suffering like a criminal, so, but I'm not ashamed of it. I know whom I believe, and I know that God is able, hallelujah, is able, amen, to guard that which I entrust to him on that day. So do you know that God is able to guard what is entrusted to him in the midst of affliction? That's point number one there. Let me say it again. Amen. Yet, for this cause, I feel no shame. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And of this gospel, I was appointed a herald, an apostle, and a teacher. I'm suffering as I am. So expect to go through suffering in life. Are you listening to me? If you're not expecting to go through any kind of suffering, then it's not the gospel. Whosoever shall suffer with him shall also reign with him. It is in suffering that we get closer to God, that we get stronger in God. Suffering does not make people quit on God. People that are really close to God will go through some affliction, will intensify our prayer life, increase our prayer life, because we know there are no alternatives. We get closer to God, and we get stronger with God. With God. Hallelujah. Amen. So of this God, I was appointed a herald and an apostle and a teacher. I'm suffering as I am. Yet there's no cause for a shame, because I know in whom I believe. You know in whom you have believed today. You know that God is the Almighty God. You know that He is all powerful God and He can do all things. You know that He never leave you nor forsake you. You know that He made the heavens and earth by His own word. You know that God is not the man that He should lie or some man that should. Do you know that? If you don't know that, you've got a problem. You've got a problem if you don't know that. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. And I'm convinced you need to be fully persuaded by which is that which you commit to Him, God is able to keep. Against that day. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. That's number one. Don't forget that. Don't forget that. God has integrity. Whatever you commit to Him, He will keep. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So as what comes out of our mouth. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 16. Amen. And then 19:24. Avoid godless chatter. 2 Timothy chapter 2, verse 16. Avoid godless chatter because those who indulge in it will become more. I'm more ungodly. About godless chatter. Don't come with tricky jokes or godless chatter. Don't leave it alone. Your mouth belongs to God. With that mouth, you pray to God and you expect God to answer. So what comes out of your mouth? About godless chatter. Nevertheless, God's solid foundation stand firm. Say with this in Scripture. Verse 19. The Lord knows those who are His, and everyone who confesses the name of the Lord must turn away from wickedness. If you claim you're a Christian, then it's time. Now we turn away from wickedness and start loving the unlovable. And start doing things according to exactly the way God wants it to be done. Say, hey, God knows the people that belong to Him. Everybody looks the same on the outside, but God knows the heart of everyone. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Everyone who confesses His name must depart from wickedness. Very interesting here. Listen to this. In a large house, there are articles not only of gold and silver, but also of wood and clay. Some are for special purposes as for common use. Those who cleanse themselves from the latter will be instrument for special purposes. Through the help of the Holy Spirit, walk in purity, walk in holiness. When you do that, then you are an instrument for special purposes. You are a golden God, not a top away. Because I don't want to act like a top away. I give it, empower you by the Holy Spirit to, not to be a top away, but a golden God, a special purpose. For the master's use. People say, I just want God to use me for the like proper way. People say, I don't use the proper way to serve the dignitaries. I use the golden goblet. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Those who claim themselves through the help of the Holy Spirit now, from the latter will be instrument for special purposes, made holy, useful to the master, prepared to do any good work. Amen. Flee people's desires of youth and pursue righteousness. Pursue righteousness. God says, flee. Flee fornication, flee adultery. Amen. You old enough to know that your body is temple of the Holy Spirit, and now, if you remember for long enough, we know that our body belongs to God. Amen. You have to build on that which you get. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Special purposes, instrument for prayer, made holy, Israel, the master, prepare for any good work. Flee the evil desires of youth and pursue righteousness. Pursue righteousness, faith, love and peace, along with those who call on the Lord out of a pure heart. When you call on God in prayer, you must call out of a pure heart. Excuse me, you know why? The Lord's heart is not so sure that it cannot save. That is, it's so heavy that it cannot hear. But it's our sins and our iniquities that kept us from hearing Him. God said, when you call on me out of a pure heart. Amen. Don't call on me from the house of fornication, of adultery, and all these things, and unforgiveness and bitterness, just calling on God in hell. No, no, no. It's a protocol. God is holy. Without holiness, no man shall see. But make up your mind this year. I'm going to walk in holiness through the help of the Holy Spirit. I'm going to call on God out of a pure heart. I won't hide anything from God this year. This year, my life will be an open book to God. God knows all things anyway. Amen. You can deceive me. Nobody can deceive God. God knows all things. Before you are born, you know what you're going to be doing. And today and beyond. Hallelujah. So, if you allow the Holy Spirit to cleanse us from all unrighteousness, then the Bible says we're fit for the master's use. And those who cleanse themselves, this is verse 21. Those who cleanse themselves, amen. From the latter will be instrument for special purposes, a golden goblet made holy, amen. This was for the master only, and prepared to do any good work. The evil desires of youth and pursue righteousness, faith and love and peace, along with those who call on God. Pure heart. So many people call on God, but some everybody call on God that they pure heart. Join those people that call on God out of a pure heart. This is that the pure heart for the church in God. Yeah, but do not have anything to do with foolish and stupid arguments, because you know that they produce quarrels. Don't have anything to do with stupid and foolish arguments. Don't argue with anybody and go to change with them. I met somebody who was looking for an opportunity to put down the saints, to put down Christians. I was asking him some questions. I was asking, well, I don't know if I can trust God. I don't know. I can hear God say the only way. I said, well, on the highway, sometimes he says one way. And if you go the opposite way, the wrong way, you're going to get and wrong. He said, well, I don't believe that. So what he was doing, I was with him for about almost 2 hours. He would ask me a question before I could finish answering his question. He jumped to another thing, another thing. He was not interested in what I have to say. He just want to repent. He just want to make mockery of Christianity. So when I found out that, I said, well, God bless you. I'm not going to force you to go to heaven. You just go to hell. Praise God. It's not a problem at all. If I happen to be right, which I know I am, amen. I haven't got a problem. Amen. So some people are interested in just venting out what they feel. I'm not really looking for answers. So you have a discernment of this. It don't have anything to do with foolish and stupid arguments, because it produces only quarrels. And the servant must not be quarrelsome, but must be kind to everyone and able to teach and not resentful. The Lord's servant must not be quarrelsome. Make up your mind this year. I'm not going to walk in. I'm not going to be quarrelsome. Amen. The Lord's servant must not go through quarreling and go through all kinds of changes like this. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. The Lord is worthy. Worthy to be praised. The 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10 to 14, 2 Timothy chapter 3, verse 10 to 14. So you, I ever know about all my teaching, my way of life, my purpose. You need to find out who are the laborers among you, who are the people that labor among you. Do you know their way of life? We're not on television, it's not like a televangelist. We see each other, we talk to each other, we pray for each other, we are used to each other. The women are not strong enough to know our way of life and your way of life and everything. We all know each other's way of life. So that's what the Bible is saying here. Amen. You ever know about my teaching, my way of life, my purpose, faith, patience, love, endurance. Then talk about persecution, suffering, what kind of things happened to me in Antioch and Iconium and Lystra. The persecution I endured. Yet the Lord rescued me from all of them. See, no matter what persecution you're going through, this coming year, no matter what persecution you are going through, God will rescue us all from all of them. Many are the afflictions of the right, but the Lord delivered them out of this world. Dear Lord, thank you, dear. Then they say, in fact, everyone who wants to live a godly life in Christ Jesus will be persecuted. So if you say you're living as a saint of what is under the Lamb, you're not persecuted, you need to check yourself to see if you're in the faith. Because the Bible says everyone, nobody is immune to persecution. People, all your names, all your holy roller and everything else, that's just the way it goes. It's part of the territory. Because your lifestyle is convicting them. And they don't want to change it. And the way you're living is making them feel bad. So they have to say something bad about you. Okay. If you're persecuted, why evildoers and imposters go from bad to worse? And deceiving and being deceived. Amen. Listen to this. So, by the grace of God, I'm encouraging all of us that whatever we have learned, whatever we have learned already, hold on to it, you can build up on top of it. There a little. You build on top from faith to faith and from glory to glory. Don't lose that which you have already learned. Find out who you're learning from and hold on to it with your dead life and build upon it. Hallelujah. He said, but as for you, continue what you have learned and have become convinced of, because you know those from whom you learn it. You know, so you know from who you learn, the Bible says, you've been coming to that church, you know from who, the kind of people you learn from. We're all together. We're not just on television. It's not the same on television. I don't know anything. You know where I live, you know everything about me, you know about each other. So if you want to go, if you hear the word of God, then hold on to it. You know, because you know who you're learning from. You know, we share the Bible. We show you that as chapters in the Bible. Hold on to what you have. Don't lose it. And then add to it. Yeah, a little. Don't hold on to what you have this year. Don't let it slip away from you. Amen. Don't put more time in the basket if you let it slip away. Just have too many holes in it. Don't do that. Hallelujah. So some people, when you're on a particular topic, they do it. They do everything right about that topic. Once you leave the topic, they throw it away and they start going back to the way it was before the topic was preached. Don't do that. Build on it. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. The alone is worthy. For the people praise. Take me to 2 Peter chapter 1. You have to build. Build. So don't forget to have to confess from your past sins. Some people live like that. They're born again. They say they're born again. But they're living as if they have not been cleansed from the past sins. We can see beyond the nose. But in this coming year, don't do that. Hallelujah. This is 2 Peter chapter 1. His divine power has given us everything we need For the God is that through the knowledge of our Lord, of Him that called us by His own glory and goodness. Through this, He has given us His very great and precious promises, so that through them we will participate in the divine nature, having escaped the corruption in the world caused by evil desire. People want to participate in the divine nature, but they try to stay in sin. God said, I don't want to stay in the sin. I am holy. If you want to go with me, then escape from the corruption that's in the world. The Bible says escape. To escape means to take off. Like there's a fire burning in the house, you don't stay there and read the newspaper. You take off running. Run for your life. Amen. For this very reason, make every effort to activate goodness. Make every effort. You have to make effort. Make an effort to grow. It takes an effort to grow. It takes changes to grow. Make every effort to activate goodness and to goodness knowledge. Hallelujah. So if you have knowledge and you don't apply what you learn, the Bible says knowledge pops up. And when knowledge pops up, you don't want to be popped up. Right. And you have to goodness knowledge and to knowledge self-control. So many Christians don't have self-control. You get to work, let's just do everything you want to do. I mean, out of work. We need to live a disciplined life. Hallelujah. Learn to get to places on time. Learn to do things in a timely manner. Hallelujah. Learn to say yes to Jesus and not to sin. Self-control. Understand that my body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. Everything that God will not do, I will not do through the help of the Holy Spirit. Because I have given Him my spirit. Amen. Self-control. Self-control. Everyone has to go to school a long time ago. Oh, my G. They have this special program that was going on. And the coordinator was calling one guy at home one time and said, hey, listen. For the sake of, I'm going to put a teacher's name. Say, hey, John, you know you're supposed to be in school. Why are you still in bed? You know you can't be doing that. Bring yourself to school. The guy came to school. And he went through to the coordinator. And he called the coordinator by name. He said, get off my case. I said, oh, goodness. Yeah, somebody waking you up to come to school. I was saying, thank you, ma'am. I'm sorry. I won't do that again. He said, get off my case. This kind of person will be fired a long time ago. Not discipline. Self-control. Amen. Oh, this person is a very good worker when they show up because it's not reliable. They show up on Monday and Tuesday or Friday, but the Friday say, well, I think they ain't feeling good. Amen. They show up late, but when they show up, they work very hard. I say, oh, praise the Lord. Thank you. That's a terrible. Get to places on time. Let the lunch time be the lunch time. I don't care if anybody is taking 15 minutes extra. Take exactly what the lunch time says. Take. Move on. People are watching you. People are looking at you. And it goes really, really wrong. You know who to talk to because it belongs to God. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So self-control. We need to work on that. Self-control. We need to work on that. After a certain time, you'll be eating too late at night. 2, 3 a.m., 4 a.m. The morning, that's lack of self-control. Hallelujah. Have a gauge. You know, eat. You know, don't eat 2, 3 hours before you go to bed. It's not the right time to eat. Just eat. Have a stomach full of food and then lay down in bed. That food will turn to fat. Going anywhere. Because lots of food in the stomach with no activities. Hallelujah. So be mindful of that. Mindful of the do things in a self-controlled manner. Amen. Amen. Like a city without the wall, it's like a person without self-control. And to self-control, you have perseverance. Persevere. So many Christians are giving up very easily. Well, I don't know how it's going to happen. Let's just see. I don't know how that's going to happen. See, you have to persevere. You have to persevere. I mean, don't give up. Persevere. Persevere. I mean, I'm very grateful to God for my wife, Lord. I'm telling you, the thing that happened in the life on the day she was coming was very powerful. I will never forget that. You know, I was praying, God said to me that I will be leaving the following day. Amen. November 16th. And I was talking to her on November 15th, and she had no ticket at that time. I said, well, forget it. They did a send-off party for her on November 15th. She had no ticket on the 15th. God told me to tell her that she's leaving on the 16th. You know what she did? I said, well, you can forget it. She said, I don't have no ticket. I need a ticket to fly. I won't be going anywhere. No. She packed her bag and put it in the back of her car and drove to work. When she got to work, they gave her the ticket to come and pick up the ticket to fly with. She don't have a chance to go back home. Amen. Persevere. When you believe that God is telling you something, start moving in that direction, please. Faith without work is dead. Amen. We don't really believe God sometimes because we don't make any kind of move. Well, I know God is telling me to do this. What have we done towards it? Nothing. So, what's going on? Talk to me. Man, she got her things ready. She, without a ticket, she packed her luggage and put it in the back of the car. Traveling internationally with no ticket, yes. On the day she was traveling, they went and gave her a sleep at work. She had to go back home with so much traffic hold up. She would not be able to get home and come back again. Hallelujah. The sleep she had in her hand, they closed like 5 o'clock. She got there for 3 or 5 minutes after the time. 3 minutes after the closing time. Why? Because God, she was leaving today. And she knows she got a sleep to pick up the ticket. She drove there. And by the time she drove there, it was 5 minutes after, 3 minutes after 5 already. When she opened the door was still open. You know, sometimes on Saturdays, when the bank closes at 12, sometimes they're running over there, and they open at 12:02, and the door is still open, and they let you in. That's because of the grace of God. That's why you have to persevere. When God says, I'm going to do something for you, you don't know what's going to happen on the other side. You have to keep on stepping. Don't stop yourself. Don't quit. Don't give up in your mind already. And I don't know why we do that. You know, God says, I'm going to do something today, and keep on pressing. Don't be the one to stop yourself. I say, well, I don't see how that's going to happen. My wife could have said, well, in about 3 minutes now, it'll be 5 o'clock already, another close at 5. Just have to try another time. She kept on going. She got there, it was after 5, and she put the door was open. You know what they said to her? Oh, I don't know what happened to the supervisor. We've been waiting for the supervisor, but the supervisor never came. As soon as she came, my wife put on the door, enter, and while they were trying to give her the ticket, the supervisor came. The Lord delivered the supervisor so my wife can go in before the closing time. Otherwise, there was no way to happen. You know, from there, she picked up her luggage and her ticket, and she went to the airport. When she got to the airport, they said, well, that's the last person we're going to check in for tonight. And they checked her in. 11:33 p.m. at night, the plane left Nigerian soil, coming to America. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're talking about a walk by faith. I mean, that really encouraged me. And I said, don't worry about it. Inside my heart, I cherish it. That when God said, I promise you something, start walking towards it for goodness sake. Do something that shows that you really trust God, that is God speaking to you. Do something about it. So it would not work his head. She packed her luggage and put it in the back of the car and drove to work with no ticket. You know, people pick up the ticket to her at work, and then she's supposed to be closing at 5, and on 5:03, she was still going there. She got there at 5:03, put on the door, the door was still open, so she went in, and they gave her the ticket, and they closed as soon as she came. She got to the airport, they say you are the last person that is going to be checking in tonight for tonight's flight. And they check her in. Do you understand what I'm saying? Don't quit. Don't give up. Don't go by what you feel. Go by what God tells you. Just keep on going. Keep on stepping. Keep on pressing. Keep on hoping. Keep on trusting. Keep on believing. Put your hope in God. The name of the Lord is a strong power. The righteous ones do it and they are saved. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. So for this very reason, make every effort. This is 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 5. For this very reason, make every effort to add to your faith goodness, and to goodness knowledge, and to knowledge self-control, and to self-control perseverance, and to perseverance godliness, godliness, and to godliness mutual affection, and to mutual affection love. For if you possess these qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective. There are too many ineffective Christians, but they are not adding all these things together. Amen. No mutual affection, no love, no perseverance, no self-control. They are Christian, but no self-control. Nothing. I'm none of the above. We got a problem. God says, add these things together. So it doesn't look like you're saved, but you forget you've been cleansed from your past sin. You're saved, but you live as if you are not saved. Hallelujah. Help us, Lord. And let me see it again. Amen. So he said, so from perseverance, add godliness, and godliness, mutual affection. From mutual affection love. Verse 8. For if you possess these qualities in increasing measure, they will keep you from being ineffective and unproductive in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Verse 9. But whoever does not have them is nearsighted and blind, forgetting that they have been cleansed from their past sins. So they are Christians, that say they are Christians, but they are living as if they are not saved. The same way they used to live before they came to the Lord. Jesus is able to live now because they have not done any of these things. Amen. Add any of this together. Amen. So therefore, my brothers, make every effort to confirm your calling and election. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. You will never stumble. I love it. The Bible says God is able to keep you from falling. Amen. There's a song that says, we fall down, we get up. No, you don't have to fall. The Bible says God is able to keep you from falling and to present you falling before the presence of his glory. But the only wise of the glory and the honor and the power and the wisdom and the dominion forever and ever. Oh, hallelujah. Make every effort to confirm your calling and election. If you do these things, you never stumble, and you will receive a rich welcome into the eternal kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Glory be to God today. His name is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Hallelujah. Glory be to God. God is a very awesome God. God wants me to tell you this. I love you, it's an everlasting life. I care about you. You belong to me and I belong to you. And people are interested in what God has to say. Just for the purpose of it. They don't really want to do God's will. They're just interested. I can amuse them. They don't be amused by what God is saying. They're not really interested in obeying God. People who have in Jeremiah chapter 42. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Remember the story of Jeremiah. Amen. With Jeremiah, the people was asking, "Oh, tell us what God is telling you to say." For 23 years, Jeremiah kept on telling them that, "Hey, come from wicked ways, turn towards God. Nebuchadnezzar is coming, king of Babylon, and he will capture you, and he will do all kinds of evidence." He's just talking. So there are people that live a lousy life. They live in the evil way. They live in a wicked life. At the same time, they want the good prophecies. But they're not serious. They're not serious. I'm telling you, this is very funny. It's funny, but it's not funny to anyone that was happening. Man, Jeremiah chapter 32. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 1, Jeremiah chapter 42, verse 1. Then all the army of officers, including Johanan and Kariah and Jezariah and Oshahiah, and all the people from the least to the greatest, approached Jeremiah the prophet and said to him, "Please hear our petition and pray to the Lord your God for the entire remnant. For as now see, though we were once many, now we're only a few left. Pray to the God, to the Lord your God, and tell us where we should go or what we should do." Does that sound good? That they're really seeking God? He prayed. When he told them what God said, they said, "We don't want to hear. That's all we want to hear." What a mess. We live in this day and age now in which people are very, very interested in what God has to say, just for amusement, not for obedience. Got a problem with that. Look at what Jeremiah told them. This is Jeremiah chapter 42, verse 4. I've heard you, replied Jeremiah the prophet. I will certainly pray to the Lord your God as you have requested, and I will tell you everything the Lord says, and I will keep nothing back from you. Then they said to Jeremiah, "May the Lord be a true and faithful witness against us if we do not act in accordance with everything the Lord your God sent you to tell us. That is favorable, unfavorable, we will obey the Lord our God, whom we are sending you. So we will go away with us. So we will obey the Lord our God." They say, "Hey, we will obey God. So want us to go away with us. Does that sound good? Tell us everything that God tells us. Want us to do. We don't know what to do. We don't know which way to go. But please tell us." There are people like that. You fast and pray, and they tell you, "Hey, this is what God is saying. You're going to do exactly opposite. Exactly opposite. Never fear." What they're hearing from God is not what they want to hear. So you just go ahead and do exactly what they want to do. Very interesting. Very interesting. They spoke. They said, "Well, may the Lord be against us if we don't do what we're going to be obedient. Whether it's favorable or not, we're tired to do this. We're going to be obedient to God." Okay? Verse 7. 10 days later, the word of the Lord came to Jeremiah. So he called together the Johanan and Kariah and the army officers who were with him, and the people from the list of the greatest. He said to them, "This is what the Lord God of Israel said, to whom you sent me to present your petition. Stay in this land, I will build you up and not tear you down. I will plant you and not uproot you. I will relented concern the Jesus have upon you. Do not be afraid of the king of Babylon, to whom you now fear. Don't be afraid of him, declare the Lord, for I'm with you. I will save you and deliver you from his hand. I will show you compassion, so that you will have compassion on you and restore you to your land." Here's his point. For 23 years, they went against God. No matter what Jeremiah said, he said, "Dad, I'm not like talking about you to me about this word anymore. Because every time I tell you, you're imprisoning me, you put me to sister, you look kind of everything, you stab me for telling you the truth." He said, "What's that? In my bone." So he said, "Well, since you disobeyed me for 23 years, no matter what I say, this is the time. So you're going to serve the king of Babylon, you're going to serve King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon." Oh, that's a bad prophecy. We don't want to do that. We will do that. Amen. If you do the crime, that's the time to go with the crime. For 23 years, no matter what he said, they did exactly what they feel like doing. Exactly away from God, what God said. Because everyone wants to do. If you serve King Nebuchadnezzar, which is what I've designed for you since you did the crime, and you serve the time, I'll give you favor. I'll grant you favor. So don't run away from punishment when you do wrong. Don't run away from the discipline of the Lord when you do wrong. Say, having, if you stay in this land of Judah, I'll be with you. I grant you favor. I do everything. They waited until he said everything. Wait a minute, we're not going to stay here. We're running to Egypt. We're running from this man. He said, well, it wasn't going to happen. If you go to Egypt, you're going to be killed by famine or plague or sword. That's what's waiting for you. None of you come back. You die there. We don't care. They said, that's not the word from the Lord. Why? It doesn't sound favorable. They were in sin, and yet they want a favorable prophecy. It doesn't go that way. Prophecy is not something to make you feel good. It's something to correct us, to reprove us. And you listen to me. That's what prophecy is for, not for amusement. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. So, verse 11. Don't be afraid of the king of Babylon, from whom you now fear. Don't be afraid of him. Declare the Lord, for I am with you. I will save you and deliver you from his hand. I will show you compassion so that we will have compassion on you and restore you to your land. However, if you say, we will not stay in this land, and so disobey the Lord your God. And if you say no, we will go and live in Egypt, where we will not see war, or hear the trumpet, or be hungry for bread. Then hear the word of the Lord, the remnant of Judah. This is what the Lord Almighty, God of Israel, said. If you are determined to go to Egypt, and you go to settle there, then the sword you fear will overtake you there, and the famine you dread will follow you to Egypt, and there you will die. Indeed, all who are determined to go to Egypt to settle there will die by the sword, famine, or plague. Not one of them will survive or escape the disaster I will bring on them. This is what the Lord Almighty, God of Israel, said. My anger and wrath have been poured out on those who live in Jerusalem, so will my wrath be poured out on those who go to Egypt. You will be a cause, an object of horror, a cause, an object of reproach. You will never see this place again. Come out of Judah, the Lord has told you, do not go to Egypt. Be sure of this, I want you today, that you made a fatal mistake when you sent me to the Lord, because I said, pray to the Lord, the God for us, and tell us everything he says, and we will do it. And I've told you today, but still I've not obeyed the Lord your God, as you sent me, and what he sent me to tell you. Now be sure of this, you will die by the sword, famine, and plague in this where you want to. What you want to say to him. When Jeremiah finished telling the people, verse 1, all the words of the Lord, their God, everything the Lord has sent to him, he told them. Azariah, son of Uzziah, and Johanan, and son of Kushiah, and all the arrogant men, all said to Jeremiah, you are lying. The Lord God has not sent you to say you must not go to Egypt and say that Baruch, son of Zariah, is inciting you against us, you know, today. To hand us over to the Babylonians so we may kill us and carry us to. So they rebel. They say no. So they went to Egypt. You know what happened? Famine, plague, or sword. They were killed. They were destroyed. Only a very handful is left. So I implore you today. I talk to you today. I believe in God along with you today. I'm not preaching to you. God is using me to preach to us. Do not say you're interested in what God has to say if you're not willing to obey. They beg Jeremiah. They implore him. Oh, please tell us. We don't know what to do. This sin is coming against us. God, for 23 years, I told you. Be obedient to me. No matter what I say, you refuse. Now the guy is coming from Babylon to come and rule over you now. Then you try to run away. You can't run away from God's judgment. Hallelujah. If you stay here, I'll grant you favor. Because that's where you're supposed to stay. But to test it, to see the difference between being led by the Spirit and being ruled by the King. He said, well, but I'm going to grant you favor, though. If you stay where you're supposed to stay, you know, humble yourself, I grant you favor. I touch his heart, and he began to you. He said, oh, no, we don't believe that. That's not what we want to hear. They swear to Jeremiah. They said, tell us everything. They said, good or evil. You know, whether it's favorable or unfavorable, we're going to do exactly what you say. Well, it was unfavorable. He said, well, we don't want to hear that. God didn't tell you to tell us this. You lied. Well, with all that they went to Egypt and ran away from the king, they died. They died. They were objects of horror. The Bible says a curse of God is upon them. So don't just hear the word of the Lord and don't do anything with it and then go against it because it's not convenient. It's not a matter of convenience, it's a matter of a lifestyle because I want to change your life forever. A new heart and a new spirit will I give you. Never go with somebody say, know the Lord, or shall come to know you from this to the greatest. Put your hope in God today. Oh, glory be to God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. So as you can see, if you read the rest of Jeremiah chapter 31, chapter 41, 42, 43, 44, if you read it, you'll be so surprised. But the woman said, to talk to Jeremiah. Jeremiah, tell us what God is saying, please. We're really interested in hearing because we think of Babylon has coming to rule about Nebuchadnezzar. Jeremiah will tell him, okay, I'll tell you what I'm going to do. God said, don't run away. God said, stay under him. Stay under him. For 23 years, which is so baby, now stay under him so I can bless you. Isn't that interesting? Jeremiah, the Lord called Nebuchadnezzar. His servant. Nebuchadnezzar, my servant, will be coming over here to take you. Isn't that interesting? God will use a worldly king to discipline his children. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Glory be to God. This year is the year we go bring to pass that which promise. Amen. That's what God says right there. I will greatly reward my people for their faithfulness this year. Do not measure my ability by the size of your problems. I will greatly reward my people, amen, for their faithfulness this year. Do not measure my ability by the size of your problem. That means when your problem is big, don't measure God with that big problem. Amen. No, I'm convinced that I am God. And I will not break my covenant with you. It's very essential and important that you listen to my voice this year. And be completely obedient to my word this year. Don't get used to turning your back on my word when it's not convenient. Don't get used to turning your back on my word when it's not convenient. Hallelujah. Put your hope in God. Put your hope in God this year. Because I'm going to do all kind of things on your behalf this year. The year of persecution, plenty of persecution is coming. But hold on to your faith. Hallelujah. Amen. You have to persevere. You have to, if you don't stand firm in your faith, you will not stand at all. Do not compromise your walk with God. Persevere. Hold on to your faith in God. Depend on Him. Oh, hallelujah. Glory be to God. Oh, I love Jesus today. I love you with an everlasting love. I care about you today. Today with thanksgiving. Thank me like you never thanked me before. Hold on to my word. Build on what you have learned. Don't let it slip away from your hand. Hold on to your faith in God. If you don't stand for me, your faith will not stand at all. You may depend on the Holy Spirit. Ministry of the Holy Spirit this year. Depend on the ministry of the Holy Spirit will lead you. Sometimes the leading will be between life and death. If you say make the left and make the right, the person can crash and die. So get used to listen to the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You send the peace of God within you. Amen. God leads us by His word. It's all of the time. One time He speaks. Amen. And when He speaks, you get used to listening. So number one, confirm. Number two, you sense peace about it. You sense peace about it. God is speaking to you, you sense peace. And then it will be confirmed. Get a notebook. Whatever God is telling you now. And when it comes to pass by, put it back, fulfilled, and put the time and date. When you do that, after a little while, start reading only what to see that come to pass. And God will train your spirit and not to hear from God clearly. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. A lot of time God revealed Himself through His word to us. So we need to get busy this year. We need to get busy. Don't start. Some people say, well, I listen to Christian music. How to be enough? No. Christian music will never substitute for the Bible, for what the Bible says. Hallelujah. Be kind and compassionate to one another. Live in the forgiving spirit to forgive people that do you wrong today. Be kind to them. Just because you are not in church or something, you have to act a fool. Be kind. Be compassionate. Hallelujah. Jesus. I'm a promise keeping God, said the Lord. I'll never leave you nor forsake you. You belong to me and I belong to you. Hallelujah. When you pray this year, pray like you never prayed before. I pray like I'm going to answer your prayer because I will, because I love you. Hallelujah. Also, whatever you desire, when you pray, believe that you receive them and you have them. Because the motion is in line with the word of God. If you acknowledge what the Bible says, if you pray something that is contrary to what the Bible says, then God is not obligated to answer, which is contrary to what it says. Oh, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Bind us together, bind us together with a cord that cannot be broken. bandos together, Lord, bandos together in Lord. There is only one God. There is only one King. There is only one Savior, and this is why we sing. Oh, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together, because that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together in love. Amen. Minister Jenny, are you able to? Are you there? Can you help us out? It's not coming out. I think that's secret preaching. Amen.
I don't know if I know the words, Pastor. I'll try. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with love. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us
with the cord that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together in love. There is only one God. All right, Sister Amma, do you know the song? Does Sister Amma know the song? Sing, oh Lord, bind us together. Where are you going to just bind us together? Okay, Sister Amma, thank you.
There is only one King.
Hallelujah.
There is only one Savior. That is why we sing. Oh, Lord, bind us together. Lord, bind us together. Lord, bind us together with cords of love. Bind us together. Lord, bind us together. Lord, bind us together in love.
One more time, help us out. I feel like I feel my help is coming now. Like I'm just sit down, help us out. I feel my help is coming. One more time, please. Bind us together.
Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together, Lord. Bind us together with love. There is only one God. There's only one King. There is only one King. There's only one Savior. There is only one Savior. That is why we sing. Oh, Lord, bind us together. Lord, bind us together with cords that cannot be broken. Bind us together, Lord, bind us together, Lord, bind us together in love. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. Praise His holy name. This year we need to ask the Lord, say, Lord, you know, show me your way. Amen. This is Psalm 25, verse 4. Show me your ways, Lord. Teach me your plain path. Teach me your path. Guide me in your truth and teach me. You are God, my Savior, and my hope is in you all day long. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Good and upright is the Lord, therefore he is trusting us in his ways. He guides the humble in what is right and teaches them his way. All the ways of the Lord are loving and faithful towards all those who keep the demand of his covenant. Amen. For the sake of your name, Lord, forgive our iniquity, for it is great. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord, for your presence. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing. Thank you, Lord, for your grace. Who then is those that fear the Lord? He will instruct them in the wilderness. They choose. They will spend their days in prosperity, and their descendants will inherit the land. The Lord confounded those who fear him and make his covenant known to them. My eyes are ever on the Lord, for only him will release my feet from the snare. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. God is such an awesome God. Wonderful God. Hallelujah. The peace of God be with you today. The joy of the Lord be your strength today. You are more than conqueror today. Lovingly and not beneath today. You are the head of the tail. Thank you, Lord, for your anointing. Thank you, Lord, for your awesome presence in our life today. This year, Lord, we make up our mind I want to hear from you clearly. Amen. Favorable, unfavorable. Reproach us, Lord. Reprove us, Lord. You know, lead us, Lord. Guide us, Lord. Direct us, Lord. Empower us this entire year, Lord. That the word goes for doctrine, for reproof, for correction, Lord. All the things that benefit that come from the word of God, let us be part of it today. Reprove us, Lord. Correct us, Lord. Hallelujah. Whatever you do to us today, Lord, to be a miracle on our behalf. Whosoever the Father loves us with discipline. And Lord, I thank you. Bring us, Lord, not in your wrath, but in your love. Jesus. And God is saying right now, I'm ever revealing God. I want to reveal myself to you like never revealed before. I'm going to reveal myself to you. I'm going to reveal myself to you. I'm going to make myself known. You're going to know me better. You're going to build a better personal relationship with me. I love you and I care about you. You are somebody to him. We belong to him and he belongs to us. This God is our God forever. This is our God forever. We belong to God. May this coming year have a great expectation. Have a great expectation. Believe that God can do all things. God will never fail. Believe that God can do all things. Hope in God. Trust in God. Hallelujah. He alone is worthy. Worthy to be praised. Lord, He's a very wonderful God. He's a terrific God. Don't quit on God today. Don't give up. Don't elevate your problem to this. Don't elevate your problem so big that God looks so small to you. No matter how big the problem is, God is willing and able and ready to help us in every situation. Be very patient with each other. Be compassionate. Be kind to each other. Hallelujah. Love is patient. Love is kind. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Isaiah chapter 55, verse 1. Come all to me, all you are thirsty. Come to the waters. You have no money. Come and eat. Come buy and eat. Come buy wine and milk without money and without cost. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 6 of Isaiah 55. See, the Lord may be found. Call on anyone that is near. Let the wicked forsake his way. That's the problem. Because the people have a wicked way. They don't want to forsake it, but they just want to add God to the wicked way. They don't go together. God is holy. God is holy. God is holy. Let the wicked forsake their ways and the unrighteous their thoughts. Let them turn to the Lord and He'll have mercy on them. And to our God, and He will freely pardon. For my thoughts are not the thoughts, but I am always your ways, declared the Lord. As the heavens are higher than the earth, so am I always higher than your ways, and my thoughts and your thoughts. As the rain and the snow come down from heaven, I do not return to it without watering the earth, and making bud and flourish, so that He is seed for the sower and bread for the eater. So is my word that goes out from my mouth. It will not return to me empty, but will accomplish that which I desire, and achieve the purpose for which I sent it. God is saying, my word will never return to me empty. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. As the rain and the snow come from heaven, and water the earth. See, when the rain water the earth, make the grass grow. That's an effect of the rain. God says, my word will be very effective in your life. Hold on. Seek me. Call on me when I'm near. For that the wicked forsake his way. Unless the wicked forsake his way, you can never seek God successfully. Hallelujah. So don't seek God and our wickedness at the same time. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. This is Hebrew chapter 1. Hebrew chapter 1 is very important. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hebrew chapter 1, verse 8. Your throne. What does the Son say? Your throne, O God, will last forever and ever. The scepter of justice will be a scepter of the kingdom. You have loved righteousness. Wickedness. Therefore, God, your God, have set you above your companions that are nothing with the heart of joy. Amen. Because love righteousness and hate iniquity, the Lord your God have anointed with God of gladness. About the family. About what is worth it. Amen. Need to repent. Maybe it's going to slow you know something. You are right. Don't be like, you know, Judah, Israel. We say, oh, I want to Jeremiah. Oh, tell us what God is saying. We're really interested, whether it's favorable or not, we're going to do it. Is that what God tells us to do? In a minute. He went and saw the Lord for you. And when he told them what God said, guess what? They went the opposite direction. Whoever destined for famine, you know, and sword and plague, they went through it. Man, they just want a favorable prophecy, no matter what they did. If a person is doing evil, the only prophet that can come is to repent and to turn from wicked ways. If you're not willing to do that, well, you don't really want the prophecy from the Lord. It's not something to suit you, a sin. A prophecy is not something that will suit a sinner in sin. a prophet is God correcting and rebuking and doing everything if we're not working with him. It's not always favorable. Amen. The very prophet that Amos gave to Eli, he was not favorable. He said that your children are teaching my offering with contempt. Therefore, people in your house will not live for the old. Hallelujah. Well, is the Lord let him do whatever pleases? This is him. So, say, wait a minute, now, Lord, you know something? You found me. I'm sorry. He didn't say that. Say, well, is the Lord let him do whatever pleases him? He had a broken neck. He fell off. He fell off and had a broken neck. He died. Two children, they both died at war at the same time. Yeah, Phineas, they died at the same time. The ark of God was captured and it's terrible. Very, very terrible end. For one reason or the other, we think God cannot do what he said he do. We think we act like God is love and God is just at the same time. Hallelujah. Are you listening to me? So if you turn away from my wicked ways, God will have mercy on us. If you don't turn, you just have to bear the consequences. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory be to God in the highest. Our life is given to all men. Our name is favor rest. This year, bring you joy and peace. May the joy of the Lord be your strength this year. May the peace of God be with you. May you find favor with good and manner that you do. May your bank be filled with plenty. May you be a poverty and not beneath. May you be the head and not the tail. May God answer your prayers and keep you strong. Amen. May you be in tune with God throughout this entire year. May the Holy Spirit lead you and guide you in every area of your life. Hallelujah. May your bank be filled with plenty. May you be a poverty and not beneath throughout this entire year. May you be the head and not the tail throughout this entire year. May you find favor with good and manner. May you be manner protected from all outcome and danger throughout this entire year. May you have an ear to hear what God said, the Lord, Holy the Spirit is saying throughout this entire year. May we be listening to the Holy Spirit for doctrine, for correction, for reproof throughout this entire year. And Lord, create in us a clean heart, Lord. Renew the right spirit within us today. May we grow in grace and knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ throughout this entire year. May we find favor of good and man throughout this entire year. May our bounty be filled with plenty. May we be the lender, not the borrower throughout this entire year. Hallelujah. We will not be deceived by the enemy throughout this entire year. So if it's possible, the enemy will be deceived. May we find favor with a man. May God answer our prayer, keep us strong, encourage our heart, and lead us by spirit, and help us to find favor in every area of our life with God and man. Rather than the family so shall prosper. But be divinely protected by God throughout this entire year. May our bounty be with plenty, maybe a problem and not beneath, maybe the head and not the tail. Hallelujah. Be alone in this world, the Lord. In the word of amen. Where are we going, sir? Hallelujah. May the peace of God be with you. The joy of the Lord be your strength. Brother T, where are we going?
Pastor, we're going to number 623.
So put the cap on it. Thank you, sir. Put the cap on the prayer there. Amen. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May God is supposed to shine upon you. Amen. May the Lord be gracious to you and turn his face towards you and give you peace. May you hear from God clearly throughout this entire year. Amen. May the joy of the Lord be your strength. May you find favor of God and man in your walk with God this entire year. From the fungus you shall prosper. You are God's people. May you find fulfillment. May you find fulfillment in your walk with God throughout this entire year. I proclaim this blessing upon you. It shall be with you throughout this entire year. Oh, glory be to God in the highest. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. May your bounty be full of plenty. May you be above and not beneath. May you be the head and not the tail. And fully obey the Lord your God and faithfully follow all his command. I give it today. Don't turn to the right or the left. All this blessing will come upon you and overtake you. You will be blessed in the city. May you be blessed in the city. May you be blessed in the country. May the fruit of your womb be blessed today. May the crop of your land be blessed today. May your life. That's what be blessed. May your banner not be blessed today. May your master and your need to be blessed today. You'll be blessed when you're coming in. You'll be blessed when you're going out. The Lord will grant your enemies. The rise up against you from the defeated before you. They come against you one way to flee. Seven different directions. The Lord will send the blessing upon your pastor, upon everything you put your hand to. The Lord will bless you and the land is giving you. The Lord will establish you as his holy people. As he promised you an oath, if you keep his commandments. The Lord of God, the Lord of God. All the people of the earth will see that you are called by the name of the Lord, and they will fear you. The Lord will grant you abundant prosperity in the fruit of your womb, the work of your livestock, and your bank account, your crop, your ground, the land in which you sow to you. And the Lord will open up the treasures of heaven, his stores of bounty, and send rain on your land, as if to bless you. That's the work of your hand. You lend to many nations, but will not borrow. The Lord make you the head and not the tail. Amen. If you pass into the command. Amen. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. In Jesus' name.
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
God bless you. Amen.